Dear respected brothers, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our salah. Ameen ya Rabbil Ameen. Alhamdulillah, we just finished Salat al-Fajr in Jumaa. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yataqabbal minna wa iyaakum salih al-a'mal. Ameen ya Rabbil Ameen. Wa yuthabbitna wa iyaakum ala al-iman wa al-tuqa wa al-huda ya Rabbil Ameen. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal fi al-hadith al-sahih, man la yashkuru al-nas, la yashkuru Allah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in that authentic hadith, whoever or whosoever is not thankful and gratitude to people, he will never be gratitude and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Especially if somebody makes some kind of favor to you or he favor you something, at least you have to tell him Jazakallahu khayran, like what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, man qala li akhihi جزاك الله خيرا فقد أبلغ في الثناء. If somebody makes something good to you, if you tell him جزاك الله خيرا, this is the best. فقد أبلغ في الثناء. This is the best you can give him. But that خير Allah will give it to him, you don't know what kind of خير Allah will give it to him. Just don't say يعني 1,000 thing, 500 thing. No, why you have to say that? Allah سبحانه وتعالى is فضل is واسع. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is so generous. And tell him جزاك الله خيرا. What kind of خير? Allah the one who knows that خير. Just tell him جزاك الله خيرا. You have to be grateful to the people if somebody makes something good to you. And I have a story, it's an authentic story. Sayyidina Ibrahim عليه السلام, one time he went to visit his son Prophet Ismail. And subhanAllah, when he went to his house, the wife of Ismail, Prophet Ishmael, she did not know or recognize Prophet Ibrahim as a father to her husband, Sayyidina Ismail. Maybe he was first time to go there after long travel or long time. She did not recognize him. And they said, Sayyidina Ibrahim, he asked her, where is your husband? She said, ذهب يبتغي لنا الرزق. يعني he went out to get rizq for us, to work, to get money, to get food for us. And Sayyidina Ibrahim asked her, كيف حالكم? How is your life? How is everything? How are you? How, whatever. She said, نحن نعيش في شدة وفي ضنك من العيش. حياة تعبانة. Our life is so tough. There is no rizq. There is no nothing. And she was complaining. And she said, Sayyidina Ibrahim, he told her, listen, when your husband come, tell him, a man so-and-so came to you. He did not mention his name. And he's telling you, change atabat darak. Ghayyar atabat darak means change, you know, the atabah, the entrance of your house. They call it al-atabah when you step in your house. Atabat darak means divorce your wife. When Sayyidina Ismail came back from his work, he was a hunter, Sayyidina Ismail. He used to hunt the lions and the big wild animals, and he used to hunt and he used to bring it to the house. He was strong. When Sayyidina Ismail came, anybody ask about me? He asked his wife. She said, yeah, an old guy. And she started describing him to her husband. That man is saying, change the atabah, the steps or your door or whatever. And she said, oh, this is my dad, and he's asking me to divorce you. أمرني بفراقك اذهبي إلى أهلك, go to your family. And he divorced her. فنو, subhanAllah, that type of women, that's why Sayyidina Ibrahim asked Ismail to divorce his wife. The type of women, يعني in a second like this, she can make big X on her husband. Yeah, she never said Alhamdulillah. And people misunderstand. They think because they cannot find a good food or a good bed, soft bed to sleep, life is tough and life is bad. No. The best thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to you, it is not a food. It is not the money. The best thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to you, if you are healthy, al-mu'afa, if he give you health, if he make, and you can recognize that. Wallahi, jama'a, the hadith said that if you wake up every morning healthy, as if you take dunya, all the earth, بحزافيرها, the big and the small thing in it. يعني imagine that every day you are healthy, you have this الكرة الأرضية, all the world in your hand. You have the all the world, الكرة الأرضية, الأرض, the earth, it is belong to you. Why? Because you woke up every morning healthy. And subhanAllah, that health Allah gave it to your children. Allah اختصروا واختزلوا all that نعم, that power, that money, that wealth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He put it in the health of your children, in your body. And you can recognize that. Ask anybody in the hospital now. Somebody has cancer. May Allah protect all of us and our kids and our families and Muslim ummah. Somebody has cancer. Somebody in the ICU or somebody in the intensive of care. He can't even breathe. He can't eat food. He can't, even if he eat, he cannot go to bathroom to take this out from his body. Imagine that. And you know the story of Harun al-Rashid مع بهلول. When Harun al-Rashid asked Bahlul, Ya Bahlul, عظني. Yes, Bahlul al-Zahid, yes. And Bahlul was giving him advice. He said, imagine you are in the desert and I have half cup of water. Only half cup of water. And you're gonna die. There is nothing in the desert except that half cup to save your life. How much you gonna give me for this half cup of water? He said, I will give you half of my kingdom. And Harun al-Rashid was almost like huge under his control. A Muslim ummah during his time. I said, I'll give you half of my kingdom. He said, okay, what about if you drink it, you cannot get it out from your body. You cannot urinate it. He said, what are you gonna give me? He said, another half. Yeah, the kingdom of Harun al-Rashid, what? In half cup of water. To put it in, to get it out. And we are doing that every day free. Did anybody ask you for money when you go to the bathroom? Some people, they pay money to get this out from their bodies. Otherwise, this poison, that urine and this soul and whatever in your body, it's a poison. You cannot put it 3 days in your body. Otherwise, you can die. Your blood will be poisoned and you're gonna die. That's it. That's why, subhanAllah, احنا في نعمة, نعمة العافية. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to you, that kind of lady, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, she will be in the hellfire. One time, in the day of Eid, alayhi salatu wa salam, he was advising women, giving them advice. And they said, women, listen. Who said that? Rasulullah. Women, listen. I was looking at the hellfire and they found most of you in the hellfire. The most in the hell, women. And the black lady, she was standing from the middle of the women. She said, Ya Rasulullah, why, why? Why? She was mad. Yeah, why, why? And they said, easily. Simply, he said, لَأَنَّ كُنَّا تُكَفِّرْنَا الْعَشِيرِ because you are denying what your husband did for you or make for you. That's why Sayyidina Ibrahim told his daughter-in-law, صح daughter-in-law, am I right? Yeah. Yes, he told her, tell your husband to change عتب الدارك. يلا. خس كم جهبة بسبب يلا مع السلامة روح يلا الله لا يردك يلا بهي دي ثانية حاج اسماعيل ثانية تقوم عاملة بيك اكس على جوزها كده في أي غلطة small mistake for my husband يلا برا get out فسب يعني احنا we have to understand this most this message for sisters when I say these lectures I record it I mean it and I prepare for it that's very important to understand this is not a joke it's Islam it's rules It's not a joke. But Sayyidina Ibrahim, why he asked his Sayyidina Ismail, his son, as a prophet, two prophets, divorce your wife. Because she was not gratitude to Allah. She was not gratitude to her husband. Her husband working outside, maybe he meets somebody good, somebody bad, somebody cheating, somebody lying, somebody maybe he's hurting him and hurting him. Why he's doing all of this outside? He was struggling to get her food. Working outside, when the husband working outside, for what? Yeah, somebody has value, somebody has no value, he can insult him, he can talk about him. Why, for what? Providing food to his family and his wife, while she's sitting home, mashallah. And he said, our life is sucks, I'm sorry, our life is bad. We have shidda. She's not grateful to her husband. But later, Sayyidina Ibrahim came back after a while, and he knocked the door. He found that good lady. Where is your husband? She did not recognize him too. My husband, he's outside. Why? He's seeking risk for us, working. How's life? Alhamdulillah, life is very good. He said, tell your husband, ثبت عتبة دارك. That kind of lady, don't let her go. Yes, she's a good lady. Why? First thing, she was gratitude and thankful to her husband. ثبت عتبة دارك. Stay with this lady, don't divorce her. When she said to Ismail, anything? She said, yeah, an old guy, man. I said, Ibrahim was old during that time. His looks like feature or whatever. And they said, oh, he's my dad. What did he say? She said, he said, ثبت عتبة دارك. يعني let the step of your door, keep your wife. Don't divorce her. He said, this is my dad, and he's telling me to keep you because he loves you. Why? Because she was gratitude to her husband. The minimum that ladies can go to her husband, Jazakallah khair. I know you've been tired. Barakallah, يعطيك العافية. It's a good smile. And they open the door. Do you know a lot of bills come today? You know, so and so calling. Somebody gonna take you to the court. You have to let him come. Let him sit down. Let him eat some food. Let him take shower. And then give him a smile. Allahu Akbar. Do you know that lady during the time of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? The mother of Anas ibn Malik. Her husband was traveling. Talha. When he came back, her boy, her son died. And her husband coming from long trip. How she can tell him? Do you know what she did? She carried her son, died. She carried him and she put him in the corner of the house. When her husband came back, she fixed herself, perfuming herself, fixing herself to him, making good food for him. The man was sleeping with her, making intercourse at night too. Everything normal. And second day she said, my husband, my Umm Sulaym, her name, I remember her name now, Umm Sulaym. My husband, you know, if your neighbor gave you something and you use it and they ask for it later, are you gonna give it to them or not? He said, yes, it belongs to them, yes, and they will tell them thank you too, because they gave it to us to use it and they return it back. She said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us our son, and he took him back. This is, he belonged to Allah. And the man was mad, not because his son died, Sahabi, because she was fixing herself for him and making intercourse and perfuming herself and making all of this while her son is dying in the house. And they went to Rasulullah, he went to Rasulullah both to complain her to Rasulullah. And Rasulullah was smiling at her and he said, Barakallahu lakum fi laylatikuma. May Allah bless your night and give you barakah in your night. And he made dua for them. What happened? Allah gave him 10 sons after that. All of them, they memorize Quran. Yes. This is the dua of Rasulullah, the barakah. Why? That mu'mina, she knew how to deal with her husband in difficult time and a good time. That's why, be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not the issue of the food, what I eat and what you eat. Everybody's eating. Cats are eating, dogs are eating. It's not the food. It's not the bed you sleep or the bed I'm sleeping. It is al-afiyah, it is al-iman, it is al-sitr. Allah's covering you up. The iman in your heart, the taqwa, salat al-fajr, coming to the masjid, praying, making good deeds, not bad deeds. You know your final destination, your mission, your aim as a Muslim. This is all together. If you have it, you have all the earth in your hand. فَقَدْ حِيذَتْ لَهُ الدُّنْيَا بِحَذَافِرِهَا. He take الدُّنْيَا, all the earth, the world life in your hand. So we have to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and ya Rabbil Alameen, yaj'alna min ash-shakirin. And this is a mission of shaitan. Shaitan never say anything. He said, وَلَا ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَنِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. Shaitan told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that. I will come to them from everywhere around them. Any tariq mustaqim, I'm gonna sit there, and they're gonna tell them go back, and they will never be grateful to Allah, to you. Then this is a mission of shaitan. If shaitan smart, if you know something, Allah love it more than that, he can say it. He said, Ishukr. Ishukr. وَلَئِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. More you ask Allah, you be grateful to Allah, more Allah will give you extras. Yes, very important, inshallah. جزاكم الله خير. اللهم تقبل منا واغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واسترنا واجبرنا واهدنا يا رب العالمين. ربنا تب علينا فإنك أنت التواب الرحيم. يا أرحم الراحمين اغفر لنا واسترنا واجبرنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكون من الخاسرين. وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه. جزاكم الله خيرا.